sick with.
Why do we turn on each other? Why do we
feel like this? Everything that has been, so shall forever be.
Sorry, what were you saying? Just if those have icky brown spots, you can toss it. That's okay. I can just cut around the bad parts.
Now arriving, Nora and Jim, buzzing in.
I realize I didn't even get to say hi.
Yeah, it's so good to see you.
Me too. Yeah. Oh God, it's been too long.
Oh, I know. We really need to do this more often.
Yeah.
What? What happened to you?
Oh.
You're in a rush, baby?
Opening gate.
Wow, that is
a
piece of garbage.
Oh, sorry, he didn't get you anything nicer.
Now arriving, Frank, buzzing in.
So how do you know everybody? Jim, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm Nora's little brother. How about you? You and Albert co-workers? You do scary robot tech stuff, too?
Oh, no. We went to grad school together.
Now arriving, Chet and Gabby, buzzing in.
Oh, please, don't mind me. I'm just going to take a quick mental picture. Oof.
I'm sure.
Deborah!
What are you doing today?
Just learning some new things.
You're so smart. If you were a woman, you'd be smoking hot, too.
Are you seriously molesting a radio speaker right now?
So is your girlfriend, Gabby.
Oh, no, Gabby. Oh, God, this is bad. This is not what it looks like.
You are too good for him. We have established this, yes?
Alert. Snow will begin in 10 minutes. Reminder, check the state's temperature.
Life hack, push your thumb here on the meat and it bounces back. Ready.
Cheers, fellas.
Oh, shit.
Deborah!
Now playing Engagement Party Mix.
There's the green
bean. You know, Chet has been molesting your newest invention.
I am not. I'm just admiring the craftsmanship.
Liar. Baby, can you get me some peppers from the fridge, please?
You got it, sister?
maybe not, not sister. Come and have your fiancé.
Okay. You got it. Love of my life.
Thank you.
Ada, I think we're getting a little parched in here. You know, maybe a little thirsty.
Oh, yeah, babe. I'll just get you some water.
No, woman. Parched. Parched.
Careful of the booze, hound.
Did you have something to say to me, asshat?
Wow, the damage, you guys. Come on, you know you have a bed you can have sex in.
Okay, booze.
She's just obsessed.
I am picking up what you are putting down.
Yeah.
So you want to do rosé all day or Gewürztraminer all
this?
Gewürztraminer.
let's do the Gewürztraminer, whatever.
I love a German wine, very high quality product.
Yes, you know, I think they just do things reich over there.
it's like German wine is the final solution to all of life's problems.
Wow, ladies, very distasteful, okay? Very
Thank
triggering.
You.
The Germans are a fine people, and the Gewürztraminer is a very fine wine. Why can't you just let the past, like, be in the past, man?
Okay, Freud.
Hey, another fine German.
Austrian, technically.
Al, come on.
What if the past just won't stay in the past, Chet?
Then you force it, usually with violence. Oh my gosh, never forget, am I right? Come on, rest in power.
He's still alive, as you well know.
Is he, though? Like, in a significant, meaningful way?
Okay. Just curious, what exactly do you want him to do?
Fix everything?
How? Huh?
Is this baby Albert? Look at this!
Whoa, is that your mom, dude? Milf o'clock.
Oh, shoes, please. Thank you. You know.
So how about that wine?
Yeah.
No. No. Jim?
No. No.
Personal space, man. Shit.
Uh-oh.
Do you know? It's okay, Frank. Go sit down. Just go sit down.
Sorry.
Fuck, can we just...
What? No.
Yeah.
No. We said we wouldn't anymore for small shit, remember? Small shit.
Small shit. Hey, hi, hello. What's going on?
Fine, okay, yeah. Just one more time. This is the last time.
Great.
Last
time. Mm-hmm. Last time, absolutely. Great. Deborah.
So, how about that wine?
Ooh, yeah.
Jim? No! Personal space!
Whoa, I just had one of those crazy, like, deja vu moments, you know, where your brain short circuits or, like, time skips for a second.
Cocaine is one hell of a drug, Nora.
Wow. Your humor is just so original.
And catch you deep?
No.
Never mind then. I thought you were really gonna.
Sorry, I didn't hurt your feelings. Yeah.
Probably should just leave.
Oh!
I don't mind helping get the timing, so once they're on me, I'm cool, but still.
Oh, well.
Guys, all of your knives are dull.
What are you doing? Chopping up bodies in here?
We like to have fun.
Okay. Oh, and who is this little lady? Oh, yes, yeah. Yeah, this is Westy.
Oh, I'm sorry. You named your Westy Westy?
It's accurate. Cute. Accurate.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Even your sharpener's dull. Wait, what is that called? When the thing that's supposed to fix the broken thing is also broken?
Ironic?
Darwinian.
Kafka-esque.
The Emperor.
Orwell.
The Blind Leading the Blind.
America in 2020.
No, it's, I've got nothing. I don't know. Apparently I've gone completely senile.
Yeah, suicide might be your only option there, Nora.
I think you're right. Deborah, kill me now.
I'm sorry. I can't do that.
You see, she even passes the Skynet test.
That's impressive.
I don't know, man.
Like, you know how those things listen to everything you say and then 20 seconds later send you ads about it? It's creepy as fuck. And it's just the beginning. Like, what if she becomes self-aware and by the end of the weekend we're all lying on the floor dead?
Jim, good news. I have located a 10% sale on erectile dysfunction medication.
Oh my God, 10%? You gotta go for that.
Humor.
Deborah, you're my fucking hero.
Thank you, Nora.
Bitch. Guys, I don't want to toot my own horn here, but Deborah can do some pretty cool shit.
All right, let's bring some stuff over before it gets cold.
Real quick, let me do this. Watch this, guys. Deborah, invent a song in the style of an 80s power ballad.
Maybe she didn't hear.
In the wild, she just analyzes a billion different songs and then randomizes some elements, builds harmonies and vocals, and then just makes it happen.
Oh, just analyzes a casual billion. Yeah, okay.
I mean, I taught her how to do that. You know, it's not like a miracle, it's just an algorithm, but holy shit, I didn't think it would work this well.
What? Yes. Is that a fucking sax solo?
Play some smooth jazz. Play, Deborah, play some polka. That's fun. Mid-century folk.
Well, folks, I'm gonna tell you a story now about a man who killed his wife and several other women.
Deborah, play some jungle. Pretty cool, right?
Yeah.
Pretty cool. All right, Deborah, stop song.
Hey,
let's go.
Yeah, everybody, come on. I need hands. Let's go. Boo. Come on.
Now playing engagement party mix.
The degree was perfect.
Hey, guys, just a quick toast. A big thank you for everybody making it out. It means a lot to
thank
us.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Six inside. Eyes by Dry Shotsky.
Doesn't get old.
Never. I've never.
And to Ada and Al's engagement.
Yes.
Of course.
Oh my gosh.
Congratulations. Congrats.
Cheers. Mm-hmm. So, Ada, I hear you quit your horrible job.
Yeah. Yeah, it didn't seem right to be his assistant and his fiance at the same time.
true.
You know, I say good riddance because I heard he was a shitty boss.
No, you know, in all seriousness, it's where we met, so I guess I'll always be grateful for that.
I'll always be grateful. I mean, Ada was integral to all of my achievements. Deborah wouldn't have happened without her.
Mm-hmm. So, Frank, Al tells us that you're finishing up your PhD. What's your focus?
Oh, please, it's boring. It's pretentious.
Well, lucky for you, boring and pretentious is what we do here, pal.
Come on, please.
Well, it's basically identity politics. Intersections of race, class, and gender, wow, with their focus on masculinity in the past 2 decades.
Hmm. How do you fit that on a business card?
It's super cool and very necessary right now.
Yeah. You know, yeah. Masculinity is actually an illusion. I don't know if they've taught you that.
You probably know that, though.
Chet.
Yeah.
I think you cracked it.
Did I?
I mean, Frank, are you taking notes? I mean, the brilliance.
You know what they need to make? They need to make an R-rated Superman, right? Where America's totally corrupt and falling apart.
So basically a documentary.
Yeah. And everything's completely fucked, right? But Superman only uses his powers for one thing. To look through women's clothing. Am I right?
Okay, sure. There's just one problem with your little pitch, Chet.
Yeah.
Porn exists, so we could just search the excavated insides of a gaping asshole for free.
Yeah. Yeah.
24/7.
Maybe you're thinking of a rape, man.
Jesus, Jim. That's offensive, okay? I'm offended. Are you guys offended? Because that was offensive.
Wow.
Come on. Okay. How about this? Hear me out. Ready? Sad man. Hear me out. He's got the strength of the Hulk, right? He's got the technology of Iron Man. Mm-hmm. He's got the daddy issues of Batman.
Needs him,
of course. Mm-hmm. He's got the whole kit and caboodle, right?
Okay.
But he can't save the world because the world's too fucked, right? And that makes him sad.
So another documentary.
Yeah.
Well, okay, imagine this. He'd be able to, like, you know, run at lightning speed.
You know, Chet's not normally a teenage moron, like, in real life. It's just when they hang out, it's like a... growing up together thing, I guess.
That's just how I see the first movie in the franchise ending. Anyway. Okay. But also, I mean, there is a B storyline there. He's a low-key pedophile. I mean, it's not the main story. Hey, that is a heartwarming redemption story. It is, without the redemption.
You brilliant, beautiful woman. You are too good for him. We have established this.
Yeah, the potatoes. Everybody likes the potatoes.
Yeah.
Potatoes are great. So the farmer, he lives like 5 miles north of here. He's this really funny guy, quite a character. And he has this thing where he lies down on top of the soil, you know, on top of the potato plants, and his body warmth is actually what makes them so tender. I don't know, I thought that was kind of cool, sort of nifty.
Superman isn't pervy.
Oh.
That's not his MO. I mean, I guess I get what you're trying to say. The helplessness of these times, is that kind of?
Yes.
I mean, sometimes I look at how fucked everything is and I think, oh, well, it's okay, the adults will fix it. And then I realize, oh shit, we are the adults, and we can't fix shit.
But then why did it feel better when the real adults were in charge?
Did it, though? Or are we just revising the past?
I invited him. I invited him.
Me. It's like the saying goes, everything is cyclical, okay? This is cyclical. We're all trapped in cycles, right? Everything that has been, so shall forever be, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You're welcome.
What? Who says that?
It doesn't matter. You know, also, I think we kind of glossed over the fact that Sad Man's a pedophile. He's going to have to save a kid at some point.
No.
Think about that.
Deborah, quote feminism, please.
Yes, literally any feminism. We just need a palate cleanser.
That's your palate.
Okay, to say gender is performative is to say that nobody really is a gender from the start.
Is that my girl, Judy?
Yes.
This is Judith Butler.
Deborah, love you.
I love you, too. Aww.
Judith Butler needs to get trounced by a 12-inch cock ASAP.
Sorry about all this. It's a lot from the outside, I know. But you'll get used to it.
It's Byronian.
What is?
when the thing that's supposed to fix the other thing is itself broken.
What?
The knife sharpener. From before.
Oh.
Wanted to know what it's called when the fixer is itself broken.
Yes.
Not Kafkaesque, not Orwellian.
But isn't Byronic, like, an irredeemable anti-hero? Do I not remember English class?
Yes, that's Byronic. This is Byronian, like Lord Byron.
Okay.
See, Byron went down to Greece to help the Greek fight for independence from Turkey, and then immediately died of typhoid.
No.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Poor Byron.
Hey, he took action to help society and couldn't. That's a man, I think.
That's good.
No, you have to stop. You can't. It's, I don't like this game anymore because it is always Hitler. No, every single time.
Okay. I got one.
All right. Are they alive or are they dead?
Dead.
Okay, dead.
Musician.
Scientist?
Nope.
Artist?
Nope. Well, when he was a kid.
No! No, that's fucking Hitler!
I got one.
You have to prompt.
I'm telling you, it's not.
Okay. What does he sound like?
Can't answer that. It's yes or no questions only.
Okay, fine. Does he sound like this? Hello, please pass the salt. Or does he sound like this?
Hello, pass the salt, schnell, pass the salt, schnell!
Jesus, Jim, too far. Again, man, come on.
Dude, it's so loud.
Whatever.
Hypocrites.
Hey. No, I'm good.
Swear.
I'm just a wine purist. Mm-hmm.
You know who else was a purist?
No, stop.
Zadoff Hitler.
Stop!
Bingo.
All right, I think I get the gist of this game.
Ooh, Frank thinks he's got one.
But is it Hitler, though?
No, I swear it's
good.
Okay. Is it a man?
Yes.
No.
Okay.
Is he a pathological liar?
Yes.
Okay.
Is he lying about not being Hitler?
No. Yes.
No!
Wow, good job, Frank.
God, no! I'm done. That's good. Guys, somebody please do a normal one, but we're 8 hours off.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Oh, don't. No, it's fine. Oh, don't worry about it.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry. Don't worry about it.
Oh,
man.
It's fine.
All right. Well, just like college, huh, Nora Bora?
Oh, Chet, it's a fucking accident. They happen. Just go back to playing the game. Shit.
How many have you had, babe? Seriously? Just Hitler, go!
Normal for her, I don't know.
Excuse me? I'm sitting right here. Are you seriously gonna sit there on your millionth beverages of the night and judge me? I didn't drink all those bottles of wine by myself.
No, honey, no, we're not judging you. We're concerned is what we are.
Yeah, on account of you being a flaming alcoholic.
Oh, Chet, fuck you. A, that's not true. I'm not. I never have been. B, I'm not. Okay? I'm just an adult woman. And as you've all fucking figured out this year, adulthood blows. Nothing is going the way that it was supposed to, and the world's falling to shit. So yeah, sometimes on a night off, you want to have a little something to get through it. Fuck! Stop acting like a bunch of fucking nuns in your tall chairs. Sorry, you're like nuns on chairs, you know what I mean?
What?
Yeah, Jesus. This is the most dysfunctional group of people I've ever met in my life. But what, your dysfunctions are like more low-key? Some of your dysfunctions are a little more discreet? Alcohol is such a cliche.
I mean, yeah, we all have our dysfunctions, but that's why it's important to choose ones that don't mess up your life too much.
Wow. Okay. My life is fine. I'm fine. Give me a break, you guys.
I mean, you have some fucking nerve, all of you. If you all could get away with murder, you would, like, legit genocide a town. Maybe tomorrow, maybe tonight.
Oh, I would definitely,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, well, see? You'd all surrender to your most base instincts, okay? You'd consume everything, destroy everything, hurt yourselves, hurt other people, and you don't give zero fucks. I know this because I know you.
Well, that's why we're supposed to have legal and social systems in place to prevent us from doing that.
Exactly. And yes, underneath our human clothes, all our fancy tech, we're just a bunch of stupid monkeys with violent urges to kill everything.
This is a freshman year philosophy class in social studies? What is going on? Nora, are you deflecting?
I'm not fucking deflecting, Chet. Why do you do this with me? Are you the only person who's ever allowed to make an intellectual point? You really want to bring it down to earth? You want to make it a Dr. Phil episode? You did me. Now let's go around the room and do the rest of you.
No, we don't have to do that.
No, we're sorry. No, actually, I think that we do. I think you all should be right down here with me. So where should we start? Maybe you, Chet? Well, okay. Our friend Chet, clearly a sociopath. No secret there. Probably multiple heads in the freezer. Would murder for sport.
Probably have. Yes. You don't know.
And am I the only person here who doesn't get Chet and Gabby? Because you're, like, wonderful. How does she handle him? The immaturity and the crassness and the nihilism. I don't get it. Is there, like, an ulterior motive here? Like extortion or blackmail? I'm not saying the whole relationship is like Truman Show, but if you need help, blink twice.
Okay.
You, Ada. Okay. Yeah, you're obsessed with Albert. Here's some daddy issues on crack over here. Because you're also obsessed with his success, and I can't tell if she wants to marry him or kind of be him. And the vibe is like, I don't know, it's just like a little creepy and slightly incestuous. It's weird. Then there's my dear baby brother who voted for fucking Trump.
Oh, man.
Fucking Jamie?
Yes, that happened.
Okay, it made financial sense at the time.
Financial sense? What the?
And Frank, I don't know you. I do know you've been an academic for like 50 years, so odds are very high that there is an adoring female student scandal somewhere in your past. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend. The student could also be male. I'm not here to judge you. I don't know you.
Okay, let's cancel Dr. Phil. No, that's enough. No. Good now.
We didn't get to Al.
No.
You are so obsessed with trying to prove yourself that you actually undermine your own dignity, and it's sad. And it's also sad that you do the weird thing with your high school feelings for me in front of your fiance. It's pathetic and makes me so uncomfortable. So please get over it. How's everybody feeling now, huh? You feel good now that you're down on my level? Getting just gut punched by your best friends? How do you like being down here on the floor with me?
No.
All right,
no.
Now I'm done. Is everybody happy?
No. Fuck, no. Deborah, pause time. Fuck, man! Jesus! What the fuck was that?
You know how she gets when she's drunk.
It's not fucking her, it's us. Why do we turn on each other? Why do we feel so compelled to just fucking pick at each other? Why can't we just enjoy each other's fucking company?
I don't know, because it's a tight group of friends and they're dysfunctional by nature, I don't know.
I guess, yeah, fine, like a family.
No, not like a fucking family, like a group of friends, like a tight group of friends.
Hey, yeah, okay. Yeah, like friends, we're just friends. Jeez, this isn't how I wanted the whole weekend to go, Ada.
Fuck out, of course not. It's our fucking engagement party. They can't look at grown-ups for one fucking night, one night. I feed them, I give them good food, good conversation. I just want one night of fucking adulthood, that's all.
We could still get that, you know, with some help.
That's the third time today? I mean, what about your rules? What about keeping it organic and...
I just want to have one happy weekend. You know, I just want to have one time where we're just good people, where we're good to each other. You know, is that really so much to fucking ask to just have one fucking happy weekend, man? With my best friends and with my beautiful fiance? Right?
Okay.
Last
one. It's gotta be.
Last one.
That's the last one.
Mm-hmm. And then from here on out, it's just organic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Deborah, rewind 6 minutes.
Yay! No, but really, can someone please do a normal one before Ada has a heart attack? Oh, thank you. I'm so happy we're all here. I really love you guys.
Oh, dude.
I'll speak for yourself, Al. I'm a little on the fence.
It's like a family, right?
No, yeah. No, not like a family. Like friends. We're just like friends, okay?
We are friends.
Hey. Friends. Hey. Yay!
This is the longest group home I've ever had.
Oh, can you believe she got so wasted?
I thought it was cute.
It might have been cute 10 years ago, but now it's just kind of sad.
Is it just me, or is it really fucking weird that they named their Westie Westie?
Oh, I don't know. I mean...
What am I supposed to do? Change my name to Human Woman? Hello. I'm a human woman.
He sounds like one of those stockbroker bros.
Get tired just looking at Ada.
I've never seen her crack a smile.
Always so nice to me.
Oh, those bastards.
They're all entitled.
No one brought anything.
$200 bottle of wine.
What?
Jim brought Bud Light.
That stupid white carpet.
I'm afraid to sit on the furniture.
Shoo. Take off your shoes.
Whose friend is he?
Tell Chet to stop being such a dick.
So stuck up.
Fake feminist.
Uh-huh.
Just take off your shoes.
OCD.
See you next Tuesday.
Super anal.
He loves that robot.
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. If that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond ring.
I thought you were a psychopath singing to yourself in the dark, but you're a sweet psychopath singing to a dog in the dark.
Busted.
I'll keep your secret.
Let your friends get you down.
What?
It's Schadenfreude. Where they want to keep you on the floor so that they can feel taller in their chairs.
What are you talking about?
I must have had a weird dream. Am I still dreaming?
No. But maybe tomorrow a little less vaping?
Of course.
Good night, Frank.
Good night.
Maybe keep singing. I think she likes it.
Okay. Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. If that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond ring.
Oh God, what time is it?
Oh God.
Wait, you look like shit.
You look awful.
Hey, everyone's up.
Good morning.
How do pancakes sound, everybody?
Ooh, good news.
Oh, I'll help.
Thank you.
So good for you.
Deborah, what is your best pancake recipe?
In a small bowl, whisk together 1 cup all-purpose flour.
Oh, good morning, Wesley.
Hey, good morning.
Can you believe that thing descended from wolves? My creature can barely walk.
Hey, she's a creature of dignity.
I kind of feel like whatever dignity she had was stripped of her when they named her Wesley.
It's cute.
Accurate.
All right, who wants Bloody Marys?
Ooh.
All right, then shut the fuck up about Wesley.
Fair.
Fair. Good.
Sore subject.
Pretty sure I have it right. Yes. Here what? It is. There it is.
I see your shirt.
Yeah.
Get out.
Uh-huh. And some pictures. Oh, look at Chet. Oh, yeah. What? Frosted tips. Oh.
Yep.
Oh, my God.
Puka shells. These
are
questionable.
Well, you had to back then. We're sitting like a bunch of goofs.
I don't understand this. Graduation. Wow. It's so good to see you, Al.
You too.
Yeah. Are you happy?
Yeah.
Things with Ada are good, right?
So good. So great.
Awesome.
Yeah.
What?
Just sometimes life feels like there's no passion. Like we're just like really good friends. Like sometimes it feels like I'm in bed with my sister.
No, Albert, no, come on. That's what happens though, right? After like a year or two or five, your chemicals change.
Right.
Can't be like fireworks forever. I mean, the friendship is the thing.
Oh, you know? Yeah, I know. Yeah.
You're probably just having like existential dready stuff because you're freaking getting married.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. You're right. It's it's throwing me for a loop for sure.
Yeah.
It's just kind of making me wonder how things could have gone different. Opportunities that I didn't seize.
Like what? Al.
I'm sorry.
You fuck.
I'm sorry.
Albert, what?
I'm sorry. Deborah!
You're probably having, like, existential dready stuff because you're freaking getting married.
Yeah, you're right, you're right. It's throwing me for a loop. Kind of making me wonder how things could have gone different. Opportunities that I didn't seize.
Like what?
I don't know. You know? I just really miss you. I miss all of you guys. I miss the whole group, you know? I love this. I love seeing you guys.
I know. Me too. You know.
Hey, give me one of these, huh?
Oh.
For old time's sake. Love that you're here.
Good seeing you. Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
At all.
Wow.
Shoes. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you.
Deborah, what time is it?
Time for you to get a life.
Whoa.
Humor.
Why is she being such a bitch to me?
Because she has great taste.
Seriously, like Al, did you put some kind of like feminazi chip in that thing?
Hey, whoa, Jesus. Cowboy.
Stop there.
Yeah.
Hey, watch out for Wesley. Deborah, pause time!
What just...
Did the dog just teleport?
What?
Did you guys say that?
No, you're...
What?
Did the dog just teleport?
No. His foot was on the lamp. He was about to...
The lamp teleported too.
Sure, okay, Chet. The dog can teleport.
got legs.
Oh, my God. Oh, that's what happened. You were about to knock it.
Okay, the lamp was going to fall. So, hey, weed's one hell of a drug.
I'm not the only one who saw that.
No.
No.
Yeah.
What's going on?
No.
His foot was on.
Okay, all right. Look, here it is. First off, not a big deal. Okay? Not a big deal.
No.
But Deborah can pause and rewind time just a little bit, and sometimes, just sometimes.
Excuse me?
What?
Yes.
Bullshit.
Not a big deal.
Yeah. Serious?
Yes. Within a window of about 48 hours, it was an unintentional side effect that I found.
You're being serious.
And I decided to keep it in there because I thought it was kind of neat and it would be a nice experiment.
Yeah, maybe. But it's just little things.
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting too messy.
Right.
It does have side effects.
Yes, guys, so please don't use it.
Deborah, rewind 5 seconds.
Oh, my God.
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting messy. It does have side effects.
Yes, guys, so please don't use it.
Deborah, rewind 5 seconds.
Oh, my God.
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting too messy.
Yes.
It does have side effects.
Yes, guys, so please.
Deborah, rewind 5 seconds.
Oh, my God.
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting messy. It does have side effects.
Yes, please don't.
Deborah, rewind 5 seconds.
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting too messy. It does have side effects.
Yes, guys.
Deb?
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting too messy. It does have side effects.
Debbie!
We only use it for emergencies to keep things from getting messy. It does have side effects.
Yes,
so
guys.
Deb, to keep things from getting messy, it does have.
Don't use it.
Deborah!
To keep things from getting too messy. It does.
Deb, rewind.
Oh.
Shits and giggles, Chet.
Stop! Just stop and please be serious. Please be serious. This is my career. It's my future. It's our life.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm gonna just need you guys to fucking promise me that you're not gonna use it.
Come on,
okay?
Guys. Just promise.
Yeah, okay.
Of course.
I mean,
what's the point of having her here if we're not gonna use it?
Fucking promise, can ya?
Fine.
I promise, yeah.
Fine.
Promise.
Good. We're good.
Yeah.
We're good. Great.
Yeah.
She's a clock, I think.
Bow and arrow. Oh, cold. But the opposite of cold is summer. Hot. Summer. Donna summer? Susie on summer?
Time.
Today was a refrigerator, Gabby. Oh,
God.
Deborah.
Oh, refrigerator!
Yes! Okay.
He was such a masculine man. Deborah?
He was a dude.
He was a cisgendered male.
Oh,
yeah. All right, let's show these amateurs how it's done. You ready, sister?
No!
Deborah,
ready, babe?
Yep.
Okay.
She was a basic white bitch.
Oh. Deborah,
she was a white girl.
Deborah,
she was a friendly Caucasian female.
Got it.
Deborah, what are you doing?
Deborah?
Oh, Deb, rewind, please.
Let's go back a hot 5 minutes. I want to talk about that again.
Oh, Deborah, rewind.
Deborah, rewind. Rewind 32 seconds.
Rewind 15 seconds.
A minute.
Deborah?
Debbie?
Deb?
Deborah?
Hey, Deb?
Deborah?
Rewind.
Rewind
my life, please.
Rewind.
Debbie?
Rewind.
Deborah?
Rewind 2 minutes.
Deborah?
Rewind 20 seconds.
Rewind.
Rewind.
I wanted to be a ballerina. Jim just wanted to be filthy rich.
I wanted to be a race car driver.
Really?
I'm sorry. No, Gabby, I've seen you drive. You cannot drive.
Where are you?
Deborah, could you pause time right quick?
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Deborah. Won't happen again, promise. Okay, unfreeze or whatever.
Wow.
What, I'm not being racist. I'm being sexist.
I'm so sorry, Deb, could you pause again? You're funny. You are funny. You are so fucking funny.
Why?
Okay. I got this. Deborah, thank you.
Oh, I can't.
Jim.
Okay, so sexism but not racism makes it okay.
Yeah.
No!
Yeah, racism is wrong. Sexism is not cool, and we're working on it.
Oh, so who is this we? This, like, a secret society of white men you're a part of?
Sexism is colorblind. If anything, it reduces racism. It bonds everyone together.
Dad, just a quick 10 baby freeze. I can't. Give me strength. I do not have the patience for this fuckery right now. I could strangle you. Fuck. All right. Woo. Mm-hmm. Why are you like this? Why are you? You know what? No. This weekend is almost over. I'm good. I'm almost. Deb? Can you fast forward? Deborah, fast forward to the end of the weekend.
Believe me, I wish I could do that.
Okay, I'm almost out of here. And you are insignificant, okay? You don't matter. I don't need you. I don't need this. And you too. Deborah, do you think?
Wow, just
naturally triggering.
Cancel him!
I'm joking. Look, I get it. The world's a fucking mess right now, especially around socio-political lines. But we all know the real plague facing our nation is the demodification of white men.
What
is the end game here? Put us on concentration camps?
Oh,
maybe we should.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, how does that make you any better?
Oh, I don't know, because we don't have a rap sheet that's two millennia long.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, cool. Just discriminate against all white men forever.
When did this shit start, dude? This, like, sad sack, I'm a victim. You sound like you just crawled out of some alt-right red pill virgin gamer basement carrying a tiki torch. Like, what happened to you?
Look, I'm fucking tired of having to defend myself to this fucking vagina committee.
Jesus.
Okay, shh, calm down. We're sorry if you felt attacked.
You know, Crooked Killery would have taken every last cent from me and given it to the illegals.
Shut the fuck up! Oh,
Jim, I don't know why I did that.
Deborah! I wanted to be a race car driver.
Really?
Oh, cool.
Sorry. Sorry, Gabby, I've seen you drive. You cannot drive.
Wow.
I'm not being racist. I'm being sexist.
Oh. Yeah, oh, Jim, you know, we get it. You are a real Martin Luther King. Deborah, for the love of God, play something relaxing.
She's too good.
Hey, I don't know about you guys, but I could use some fresh air.
Take him outside, please. He's like a dog. He needs to be walked. Take him out.
Come here, boy. Come here. Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy, Jimmy?
No, I'm just saying words matter. Actions matter.
To who? And why?
It's like that story about the man.
Oh, love that story. It's a classic.
You know, the man who fucked and stole, killed, and then he told himself, before I die, I will repent. I will take it all back, and then I'll become a good person, and then I can die in peace.
And
he never got the chance to, because he died while fucking a prostitute with cocaine on his face and a cheeseburger in his hand.
Wow. And then what?
That's it.
Is this a joke?
No, it's not a joke. It's one of those, what do you call it? The morality tales.
How so? How is that? I mean, that guy's my hero.
I mean, I don't know. He won't go to heaven.
Heaven? Wait, 12?
No, not like a literal heaven. Like, heaven as a metaphor.
What's a metaphor?
There you go, Frank.
Yeah. No, but Jim, I mean, I get what you're saying. You know, actions should have consequences. We should be good people, blah, blah, blah. But we shouldn't do it because of a heaven, right? We should do it because we just fucking should just be good people, yeah, right?
Except for the fact that the universe rewards bad deeds. It often overlooks the good ones.
But I thought you believed in redemption, man. What about sad man?
I don't think you quite understood what I meant with sad man. I mean, the guy was a pedophile. But yeah, redemption isn't a realistic concept. And that's why we created it, so that we can feel good about about being good, you know? To make it easier for suckers like you to behave in society.
Okay, so if nothing matters, then maybe I should just stab you right now.
I mean, sure. Yeah. I mean, it'd be pointless, but go ahead.
It wouldn't be pointless.
Get this man a microphone.
You gotta stop.
He's a regular Jerry Seinfeld.
No more jokes for you in this town.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you want to see where this goes?
Let's just go back inside, guys.
Yeah, calm down.
Inside.
Oh, holy shit! What the fuck,
Jim?
Jen, are you okay?
That felt good.
Oh,
I've always wanted to do that shit.
Why would you do that?
Shit.
Wow. Okay. Little Jimmy's all grown up, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly the fucking point. I'm 20 fucking years old. But no matter what I do to you guys, I'm still 12. Eddie, you guys, I'll still be 12 when I'm 80.
Why don't I make you piss your pants like you did when you were 12?
Okay.
Line? No.
No. It's...
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay.
Hey, Nora. You want to help me out in the garage? Just grab some drinks. It'll only take a second.
Yeah, sure. We're gonna get it.
Okay.
All right. We having fun?
Yes. So much.
Good. I'll
take it. Oh, thank you. That was good. Love it. And they say chivalry is dead.
Never for you, madam.
Thank you. Albert, what the fuck?
Fuck.
Dude.
Deborah.
Okay. Take that from me.
Albert, what the fuck?
Fuck. Deborah, rewind 20 seconds.
Did you just do the time rewind thing?
Yeah.
Why?
I mean, it's not important.
But I can, like, still feel it. Like, almost remember, but it's weird.
Yeah, that can happen. It's like... emotional residue. It's like a side effect. That's kind of why Ada and I didn't want you guys using it.
What the fuck is emotional residue?
It's kind of like, do you remember in 11th grade when I asked you out in front of all of your friends?
Oh, no.
And you rejected me. And you said something really mean to me, and it totally demolished my sense of worth.
You were kidding.
But the next day, you felt so bad that you came over with a plate of homemade brownies.
Yeah.
Yeah. They were not good. They were really bad.
Really?
Did I say that?
Yeah. Oh,
but you were so sweet, and you apologized, and I forgave you, and we've been best buds ever since, right?
Yeah.
Well, the funny thing is, I don't even remember what you said. The thing that hurt my feelings and humiliated me in front of everyone. No idea. But I do remember the pain. That I can recall. Very vividly. So that's what it's like when Deborah rewinds time. It's emotional residue. It's like a scar. You can remember it here, but not here.
Albert, I'm so sorry.
You have nothing to feel sorry for. I've always loved you. You know that, right?
I love you too, buddy. So much. Forever. Mm-hmm. Al, could you do me a favor? And just maybe not do the time rewind thing with me alone anymore.
Then stop fucking leading me on.
Excuse me?
Fuck. Deborah.
Can you maybe not do the time rewind thing when we're alone anymore?
Okay, yeah. I promise.
Okay.
Come on, guys, grab
time.
We really need to stop having a full-blown meal every 5 minutes.
Do we, or do we just continue?
Oh, she makes a good point.
All right, everybody, dig in.
I can't.
Oh. Gabby, have we told you yet that you were too good for him?
Why do you keep saying that?
Well, I mean, geez.
Look, there is no conspiracy theory. I am not being blackmailed into dating him. We are not on a freaky reality TV show. I am with him because I care about him, and he is good enough for me.
Like, how? Why?
He's not like this. You know, like, out in the real world, outside of this weekend, he's kind and compassionate and mature. It's just this place with all of you people, he just steps into a time machine and he is 16 years old again, just to try and impress you all.
Oh.
Or live out some nostalgic fantasy that died a really long time ago, but honestly, by this point, it is getting really tired.
Yeah. Yeah, hey, you know what? We're good. We all agree that in here he's an ass, and we're good.
Yeah, but you see, I don't blame him. I blame you. Because the truth is, I don't like you. Oh, God. Wow, I don't like any of you. I think you are a group of the most selfish, highly dysfunctional, rotten people with zero core values that I have ever met. Not you, Frank, I don't know you. Can't you feel how fucking torturous these eternal, endless, never-ceasing weekends are? They are like a very, very heavy penalty that I have to pay just to be with you. And God, I can just imagine the shower that I am gonna take when I am done with all of this. And I can wash away the shit that is all of you and get back to real, normal, actual life. You know, the present tense where people act like adults. So no, I don't think that I am too good for him. But I think maybe, just maybe, he might be too good for all of you. Again, you know what? Fuck it. Give me some of this cake. Oh, God.
Ooh. Thanks for that. You are a fascinating specimen.
Specimen? Please elaborate.
No, I just mean that I'm fascinated by your nihilism shtick.
Well, it's not a shtick. It's a way of life.
Right. Right, well, but... But the... Nothing matters, there are no consequences. The universe doesn't care, so neither should we.
Yeah?
It's...
reductive, no?
Well, that's the point. You know, it's reductive because life is reductive.
You're reductive.
I don't think I'm reductive.
No?
I could reduce you. I just think the nihilism shtick is a crutch.
A crutch?
As a way of dealing with complex emotions. If, say, their life hasn't turned out the way they wanted to, maybe they peaked in high school. Maybe they have a meaningless, dead-end job. Maybe they're with a woman everyone claims is too good for them. Sure, it would be tempting to turn off those emotions. Or at least pretend to.
Wow. You're a real Frank, Frank. You know what else is reductive? Observing people from the sidelines, thinking you know everything.
The sidelines is the best place to observe. It's where you get the fullest picture.
Yeah, but none of the details. Right? Now that's a crutch, isn't it? Watching, not playing. Why don't you step into the court sometime,
Now listen to me, Frank. You can classify me, measure me, analyze me, intersect
Frank,
me.
Frank, don't
shove me into all sorts of neat little theoretical rubrics. Now let me tell you something.
Frank.
I will not fit.
Deborah?
Let me tell you something.
Deborah?
Get your hands down. Deborah? It's a place to observe. It's a place where you get the clearest picture.
And none of the details.
Hey, Frank, I'm gonna take your BFF Westy out for a walk. You wanna come join me?
I should go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Come on.
Thank you. It was getting a little intense in there.
Yeah. Well, that's Chet for ya. Expert button pusher.
Yeah. Sad thing is, he's not wrong. The sidelines are my favorite spot. My default spot. It's where I'm safe. You know, throughout my academic career and ever since I was a kid, I've focused on this one question. What is an American man? Is there such thing as an American man? Am I an American man? My family's not from here.
Well, I guess technically none of our families are from here.
Yeah, but that's reductive.
Well, you're reductive.
Yeah, I guess I've just never felt like a real American man, whatever that means. I've always felt one foot in, one foot out. I feel like an imposter when I try to participate, but no one judges you when you're on the outside looking in.
Yeah, instead you get to judge them.
Exactly. It's a survival mechanism. A quiet power one can wield over his fellow man.
Yeah, totally. Like you can't lose if you don't play.
Right, but it can also feel incredibly maddening, emasculating the passivity of it all, the surrendering of agency.
Yeah, you can't win if you don't play.
Right. Sometimes I want to jump in, but.
No, I get it. It's scary. Like I've been there. You try going through all that while having a vagina.
Yeah, well, try going through all of that while also having a penis.
Stalemate, huh? Look, all I'm saying, tough like shit. His high school bullshit make you reconsider your whole identity. It takes some getting used to, all of them. It's like when they get together, they enter this weird primal mode, you know, like a herd mentality. They start taking on roles.
Like a family.
Well, no, I mean, not like a literal family, because we're not related, you know. It's like a friends, like a friends group, a group of friends, right? Because we're not related, so, yeah.
I can't help but notice that that's a particular trigger for you. It's none of my business, but do you want to talk about it? Okay, what is, what is happening? Is that a yes?
I'm just, I have a little trouble breathing.
Here. Use this. It's only gently used. I'm kidding, it's not been used at all. Use it.
Oh,
There's kind of something I need to get off my chest, if you know, since you offered and everything. Okay, so you know how Albert is like the biggest tech nerd of all time, right? And it's like super cute and stuff, so I wanted to get him something as like a surprise that would be equally nerdy. So, he'd been geeking out for a few weeks about this at-home DNA test that he took, and I thought, oh, you know, that'd be really great. Like, I'll do it too, and then, you know, we can bond over how we both have 2% Swedish ancestors, or we share some chromosomes or something, right? Like, it'll be super romantic. So I did. And the test came back, and it turns out that we do have a lot of chromosomes in common. Actually, we have all of the chromosomes in common.
I'm sorry, I don't follow you.
So it said, congratulations, you have found your biological brother.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
How?
I don't fucking know, man. I don't know. I mean, what, my parents are neglectful psychos? I live in France. I haven't spoken to them in 9 years. And I mean, Albert doesn't know who his biological parents are. And I mean, what the fuck? I mean, what the actual fuck? I mean, fuck! Fuck, Frank, what the fuck do I do? I mean, this doesn't happen to real people, right? This is like some soap opera plot finale bullshit, right? This doesn't happen to people like me.
Fuck.
Frank, what the fuck am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to leave him? I mean, I love him. Ooh, my entire life is his, and I know that sounds cheesy and dysfunctional and codependent, but that is not the issue right now, okay? We need to focus.
I'm sorry. Oh, God.
Nora, all of them, so close, and I guess, I don't know, I was jealous, or I felt like an outsider. I guess I just want to be part of the family, you know? Not like literally, you know, like, what am I gonna do for you?
I don't know. Well, not that.
Oh.
For starters.
Sorry. I just.
No.
It's a lot.
No. I know. It's okay. It's okay.
Oh.
Oh. Great. Oh no. Oh. Seriously, but no. Stop.
Fuck.
Oh. I'm sorry. No, it's okay. I know that I seem appealing in the sense that I'm not biologically related to you, but that is running away from the problem.
No, I know. I'm sorry. That's me. I'm going through a thing, and I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Yeah, no, it's cool. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I mean,
No, please.
Right, no.
Seriously?
No, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, no. I'm cool.
Okay.
It's okay. It's cool.
Okay.
I'm cool.
No, help.
Want to stop molesting the nice robot lady, Jim?
What the fuck? She's a toaster oven. Fuck you, Deborah.
Fuck you, Jim.
Man, you guys have gotten so good at that. Playing the victim.
Okay, Jerry boy. Who exactly are you referring to when you say you guys?
You know.
Okay. You know what? I think it's, dinner o'clock. Huh? Chet? Pasta duty?
Didn't we just have dinner?
Nope, that was more like a dunch.
Oh my god, I feel like we're stuck in a loop.
Yeah, a high-calorie food loop.
Perpetual state of prepping for dinner.
Don is infernal.
No! It's called being in your 30s, and this is what we do now. Okay, we make food, and then we eat the food, and then we make more food. That's what we do, because no one enjoys sex or relationships anymore, so this is what we do.
Speak for yourself.
All right, our dreams are dead. Our dreams are fucking dead, and the world is dying, and the planet is fucked, so this is all that we have. Food is all that we have, so can we please just make some fucking food, Chet?
All right, I'll boil some water.
Thank
Jesus.
You. Thank you.
Thank you.
Albert, what the fuck?
Deborah?
Albert, what the fuck?
Deborah!
Albert, what the fuck? Hey guys, I want to be really honest with you, and I just wanted to have a nice fucking weekend with you asshats, right? I just wanted to cook and eat and have a good time hanging out, but you know, all that is fucking fucked. My marriage is fucked, my future is fucked, and none of you fucking want to have dinner anymore, so I thought we'd do something really fun instead. Albert, take off your fucking shoes! You see, so Albert is not the only mad scientist in the family anymore. All that time that I was working for him as his assistant, I was not just answering calls, I was actually kind of learning things at the same time. And so, I made my own invention. So, meet Blaine. All right, guys, which has nothing to do with any of the rest of you fuckers, okay?
Babe, what is this?
Oh, hey, babe. Yeah, this is Blaine. Oh, say hi, Blaine.
Yo, yo, what's up, party people?
Douchebag.
You are.
Deborah, say hi to Blaine.
No, thank you.
What a bitch.
You are.
You are.
You are.
You are. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
My balls.
So, fuck you. Blaine, can you create original songs from scratch like Deborah?
No, but I can recite the lyrics to the entire Smash Mouth discography.
Oh, yeah, that won't be necessary.
Ada, what the fuck?
What, Albert? What? You're the only one who can be a genius in the family. You want all the attention. You want all of Nora's attention.
Hey,
oh,
hey.
Oh, fun fact, you guys. Know that he based Deborah's personality on Nora's personality. Isn't that just the cutest thing you've ever heard? I mean, they're best buds. It makes me fucking sick. But it doesn't matter now, because I have Blaine, right?
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb. And
wow. Big Turing test winner over here.
Fuck you, Albert. Fuck you. Fuck you, right? But you're the only genius. We can't celebrate anyone else. Why don't you go back to molesting Nora while no one's watching, right?
I'm sorry, what?
Yes, I'm sorry. But you know that like creepy crawly feeling you're getting like someone's feeling you up in your sleep? Well, he's actually been doing that to you. So, but you know what? You can have him, because I can't have him, because he's my actual fucking brother, so there's that, and it's gross, and it's, you know...
Say what?
What?
Yeah, I didn't tell you, but I got tested, and we share the genes, Al. We share all of the fucking genes, so you got what you wanted. Congratulations, we're fucking family, bro.
Brother? Really?
Yep.
No. It explains a few things.
Fuck you, man.
So much to do, so much to see, so much wrong with taking the back streets. You never know if you don't go. You never shine.
What do you mean he's been touching me?
Yeah.
I mean, you wouldn't do that, Al. We're best friends. We're like family.
Yep, definitely.
Albert. Al. Have you been touching me?
Deborah, rewind 5 minutes. Deborah, rewind 5 minutes.
Why don't you have Blaine do it?
Deborah, rewind 5 minutes!
No.
So you've been using her? To what exactly to get your rocks off? To violate me without me knowing? Without any consequences?
It's not like that. It's not like that. I am not one of those people. I'm not a fucking creep, okay? I'm a good guy. I'm a good guy. You know that. We're best buds. Fuck, Nora. You lead me on.
What?
Neil, on the way you look at me, the way you've always looked at me, like there's something more, right?
No.
Yes. No. Look, I know. I know that I used to be a pathetic, virgin loser, but I've worked so hard to make something of myself, to prove that I am worthy of you. I am successful. I am self-made. I am wealthy. I have it all. I'm a fucking catch. Do you not think that I deserve you?
Deserve me? No, I'm not a prize cow, Albert. I'm not property.
I fucking earned you.
No, you didn't. I am not a puppy that you get to buy and take home. I am a fucking human person.
You are the object of my affection.
I am not an object, Albert. I am a subject.
You are the object of...
I am not an object, Albert. I am a subject. I am a character. I'm the main fucking character in this.
Yes. Yes. That's what it's always really been about, huh? Huh, Nora Bora, right? I mean, in your head, you are. In your head, you live in the past. In your head, it's still 2001, and we're all best friends, and you still have your whole life ahead of you, and you're the main character, and we still love and adore you. You've been cutting around the bad parts long before Deborah ever came along. You curate your memories. You only remember the best parts, the good stuff, the greatest hits. Because in here, you are the main character. In here, you are the center of attention. But out there, you're a fucking drunk and a spinster and a loser who never really amounted to all that much.
Dude, that is some creepy ass professional grade gaslighting bullshit right there.
Fuck you, Albert.
Oh, fuck you.
Fuck you both.
Baby.
No, don't you dare talk to me, you entitled cheating rapist scum.
Jesus, you guys are being such a bunch of Jews right now.
Oh, fuck you, what you Nazi fuck.
God damn it. You are a group of fucking self-hating, privileged sadists. I mean, you play whack-a-mole with each other's self-esteem like the world's worst circle jerk, and then you congratulate each other on being the world's best friends. Oh, like you're a fucking family, right? Right? What? Like the fucking Manson family? Like, maybe.
On the bright side, I do think the pasta's almost ready.
God, spoken like an actual nihilistic
psychopathic asshole! Dude, enough with these fucking endless adult dinners.
Everyone enjoys friends' dinners, Jim. Everyone.
God, nobody wants to sit to a fucking 8,000 meals.
We are in our 30s. Weekend. We are dying. The planet is dying. Dinners is all we have left, so fuck off.
Look, I'm not a psychopath, okay? I'm not a nihilist. I'm none of those things. I know I may be a bit much.
I do, and I know that you're too good for me, okay? I'm aware of that.
I'm too good for you.
Oh, my God.
This is fucking insane. Why are you crying?
Oh, take a breath, Jimmy boy. Don't piss your pants, okay?
Fuck you. You bleeding heart snowflake fucks with your feelings.
Oh, I'm so triggered. Oh, he looked at me funny. Oh, I got raped.
Fuck you!
Critical, backwards-ass, waste of space, Nazi fuck! I am sure you have some really great final solutions to this problem, huh?
Hey now, you're an all-star.
Shut the fuck up! Blaine, Deborah, rewind 5 minutes.
Hey now.
Now playing whatever the fuck I want.
Can't trust a woman.
But a cunt.
Oh, fuck Jesus. You!
Oh, fuck you!
Hey.
Mind your own fucking business, Frank.
Maybe everyone can relax.
Yeah, why don't you go back to the fucking country you came from?
Jesus, lay off him!
Oh, why? So you can lay on him?
Fuck you. Okay, guys, Frank's right. What would I do? We have to relax. Okay? Everybody take a breath. Turn the temperature down. This is... We don't have to be like this, okay? We don't need Deborah. We can control time because we can control ourselves because we are adults in our 30s. We can be civilized.
Christ, you were so fucking boring when you were sober.
Rewind
36 hours.
No.
Why not?
Futile. Results will be identical.
No. They won't. They won't.
Can you break it?
What?
The cycle.
1000%.
Of course not.
Goodbye.
Frank! Frank, no! No, no. You have to... You have to tell her we can change. We can.
We can't.
Yes, we can.
No, we can't.
Yes, we can.
No, we can't.
Yes, we can. Oh, no. Frank. We have to try. Please. We have to try. We can.
History is doomed to repeat itself.
Please, Frank, I need this.
Why do you need this?
A happy ending for the main character.
Deborah, we will change. We will change things.
Okay.
Keep brown spots, you can toss it. If those have icky brown spots, you can toss it.
No, that's okay. I can just cut around the bad stuff. You know, I've been in there cooking up a storm, and I realized I never even got to say hi.
Hi.
Hey.
It's so good to see you.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, it's been so long.
I know. We really need to do this more often.
Yeah.
Yeah.